morning, and welcome to the St. Paul African Methodist Episcopal Church, the former home church of Rosa Parks. Whether you are joining us virtually via Facebook, teleconference, or YouTube, we are glad to have you in the service, where you will experience the church of power, persuading others with eternal redemption, under the anointed leadership of Reverend Dr. Agnes Lover. Come on in and get your praise on.
Receive his degree in economics. Our pastor has a Morehouse man. month of May. And we just praise God for the great work that He has done and He is doing in Gideon's life, in Anthony's life, and in Brad's life. And may God continue to enlarge their territory. Amen. And now we have come into this place. We gather in His name to worship Him. So forget about yourselves. Concentrate on Him. And let's worship Him. Praise God from whom all blessings flow.
time of uncertainty and all around us, death and destruction and decay. Lord, we thank you. We are still here. We have an opportunity to serve you, to worship you, to praise you, to thank you. To thank you this morning, Lord. Yes, Lord, we don't know what tomorrow holds, but we know today we are still here. We have an opportunity to love one another, to thank you, to praise you. We worship you, Lord. We thank you. Thank you, Jesus. We don't know what your brothers are doing tonight, but we know we're here. Lord, I thank you. So much is going on, so many families suffering, so many people dying. But we still say thank you. Lord, help us. Help us to have faith, Lord. Increase our faith. Strengthen us that we might run the race set before us. Help us, Lord. These are uncertain times. But we're holding on and we're praising you, we're thanking you, we're waiting patiently, saying thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your gift. Thank you for your sacrifice. Thank you for keeping us. Lord, I just thank you this morning. My heart is filled with joy. I have an opportunity. Help me to take advantage of it. Show how much I love others. Lord, help us to show that you love me. Help us all to have courage. So thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. In the name of the Most High God, we praise and honor you. We bless you. We magnify your name. And we say thank you. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Yourself is so dirty. Can't bloodshed of my body with many animals, and these animals do not all have the same function. So in Christ, we dominion on one body, and each member belongs to all of them. We have different gifts according to the grace given to each of us. If your gift is prophesying, then prophesy and according to you, faith, it's your faith.
Lord.
this morning. In the Holy Ghost rich and power, I decrease the Father God you increase. But I want to thank you for waking me up on this wonderful day. Thank you, God, for coming while we slept last night. Just grateful to be among the living on this morning. Now, God, Holy Spirit, go forth. Use you to do your will and your will alone. And I thank you for what you've already done. This I ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
In the absence of our pastor, I thank you for the opportunity to stand behind the sacred text on today. When I was reading over my sermon, I got nervous. This is sacred ground, and it's something you don't get used to. Our scripture has been lifted this morning, but I'm going to read to you the second verse, Romans 12 chapter. Do not conform to the patterns of this world, but transform by renewing of your mind, and then you'll be able to test and prove what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will. And for a thought this morning, changing our lives by changing our thinking.
Situation. He loved you so much, he sent his only son to die on the cross for you. The word of God is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. Matthew 4:4. This is a part of your transformation. Know the truth for yourself. Read and study the word. Learn how to live by God's command. Don't allow anyone to feed you any false information. The Bible speaks of false teachers. You hear them on radio. You got to make the judgment for yourself. That's relationship. Don't you know the Holy Spirit will speak to you anytime something's out of order? Recognize who God is. Allow him to control your steps, to order them. If something is wrong and you hesitate, that's the Holy Spirit warning you. Stop. Listen. Do you not know we would make the wrong decision if we only listen to God? He will guide you on the journey. He will protect you when dangers run after you. Listen. Have an open ear. Be able to walk with him. Talk to him. Tell him all your trouble. This is how you're being renewed. He can't do it if you allow him to come into your life. He's here. He's in his building this morning. The anointing of the Holy Spirit. Have a relationship with God. And God wants you to do something else. Be humble. Be humble. And when you're humble, God can use you. Renewing of your mind. Change the way you do things. About God is living the life to see him on the other side. He wants you to be understanding and courtesy to help others. Do you not know people never see God when they see you? Be a beacon of light. Show the love God has for you how you change your own life. We all haven't been this way, but by the grace of God, we're living for him. Life changes for the good, and you have to live according to God's command. We need to break away from negative pattern of thinking. And what I mean by that is, don't allow somebody to bring you negative thoughts. Don't let people tell you something that is not true. God doesn't want you to have that negativity in you, because once it gets on the inside of you, it reflects how you act. God wants you to live a life of happiness and joy. Right. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Philippians 4:4. In our daily walk, we must have a mind on doing the right thing at all times. God expects us to do right. Why do you think he sent his son to die on the cross for our sins? He came that we would have the right of a true life. But we can't have it if we're not living for God. We can expect to receive blessings, but we're not doing what God asks of us to do. We have to be an example for others. Like I said, people don't see God, they see you. And when they see you, they know it's something different, and they want to be like you. This is how you draw other people to God, by letting your light so shine. Show that your life has been changed. You have been renewed, bought for the price by God. Shine for Jesus. Live for him. Stay away from destructive thoughts. Tell Satan he can't drive the bus and you be a passenger. Don't allow him to get into your space. Let him know to leave. And the way you get rid of Satan is call the name of Jesus. One for the Father, one for the Son, When we stand firm on the word of God, He will take care of us. Jesus wants you to be successful in everything that you do. Stand firm on the word of God. Recognize your potentials and receive what God has promised you. Be strong. Walk with your head held up high. I lift my eyes to the hills, which come to my help. My help comes from the Lord, who made the heaven and the earth. Psalms 121, 1 and 2. Renew your mind by looking to the life of Jesus. You have a new thought of living. Your goal is living because you're free from sin. Jesus died for our sins. He renewed your mind when He went to the cross. He died that you have the right to live for Him. Beware. Satan is looking and watching every day how to get you. But when you know what you know, stand on the word of God. Take care of opportunity to serve Him. Do what God asks of you to do in the name of the Lord. Keep living, keep watching, and keep praying. God is awesome. Every day that He wakes you up, He's renewing your mind to live for Him totally. It isn't easy, but God will cover you and keep you. And God is here in His building. He is with you. Allow Him into your space. Live for Jesus. Renew your mind. Renew yourselves. And look up to the hills will come at your help. Because without God, we cannot make it. We're not here by ourselves. He is here to carry us through. When the road gets rough, look up. God will carry you. And He will bless you even more. May we pray. Father God, thank you. Thank you for your word to renew your mind and your spirit to live for you, to allow you to come into our lives and guide us. We thank you for all that you do and all that you do for us. Now bless each and every one here on this day. This we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Spirit abiding within us. It's not something we do on our own, it's what God Thank you.
fellowship of the Holy Spirit. Rest, rule, and abide with each of us. Today,